me this morning from Neurotech International is Tom Duthy. Tom, good morning.
Andrew, hi.
Good to be speaking, Tom. Look, firstly, give us a bit of an introduction here to Neurotech.
Absolutely. Thank you very much. So Neurotech are a biopharmaceutical drug development company with an innate focus on neurological disorders, predominantly in paediatric or children. And we also really like market opportunities where those paediatric disorders tend to be on the rare side. And the reason we like that is because they tend to be unencumbered drug therapy markets. And so our lead product is a cannabis-derived extract, which we formulated, which is very high in the right kind of cannabinoids that emanate from a cannabis plant and low in a compound called THC, which offers more of the euphoric sort of sedation type effects and is not suitable for kids when you're running drug trials. So, that is our rhyme and reason as a company. We're treating this extract as a drug, as I mentioned, and with that comes an element of regulatory and clinical rigor. And we're very focused on, hopefully becoming, one of the very few companies that are able to navigate regulatory pathways and see a product registration, principally to help kids that are pretty sick, quite honestly.
Well, look, firstly, tell me about this paediatric autism spectrum disorder study.
Yeah, so we've been very focused over the last 12 months in proving that what we see in the laboratory translates to human patients, notably children. So we ran a 14-patient, what we say is a phase 1-2, safety study, essentially. And that was looking at different amounts of our drug products in these level 2 or level 3 ASD children. And that means they're pretty sick, like moderate to severely ill with ASD. And we really wanted to show that the drug was safe and they could tolerate different levels of the drug. But interestingly, what we did see after just 1 month of treatment was that there was a 93% of patients, so 13 out of 14 patients that received our product actually showed improvement and strong improvement at that in their ASD symptomology, so their symptoms and their severity of their illness. And that was really pleasing. And probably a little bit unexpected at such a short duration. So from here, we are going again, if you like, and putting together a study protocol for a phase 2/3 trial in around 50 children. And that would meet a high watermark in terms of trial design and really allow us to talk to the US Food and Drug Administration and ultimately the Australian Therapeutic Goods Administration as to, what we need to do after that trial. But this one will give definitive level 1 evidence of effect.
And what else is in the pipeline here for this drug?
Yeah, so we're blessed with, 50 years of clinical and medical research on the use of cannabis extracts, synthetic cannabinoids, which are the sort of the key component. There's 100 cannabinoids in cannabis plants. So we're blessed with substantial literature that supports our investment thesis of picking diseases or indications where there is a strong neurological effect driven by what we call neuroinflammation, so inflammation in the brain. And so we've been, cherry-picking, for want of a better word, particular disorders in children where we know there is an inflammatory effect. And so we have a planned study in cerebral palsy to help children which have that spasticity in their muscles to alleviate some of that, or hopefully more than just some of it, by a daily treatment with our product. That's a second disease indication, if you like. This also has applicability to other rare pediatric disorders, and we have an undisclosed one we're currently working on, which we'll be delighted to share with the market in the coming weeks ahead. But that will be a third rare pediatric disorder that we're very excited about because it's currently untreatable and it's very severe.
When are you looking to kick off the cerebral palsy study?
We plan for a recruitment to commence in Q1 of 2023 calendar year. We hope to secure human research ethics committee clearances before that, obviously, because we would need those to start the trial. So there's been a lot of, we're a very small focused team and a very small company, so we can't get too ahead of ourselves, but we're very focused on applying and developing study protocols and submitting those to our friends at the Human Research Ethics Committee groups and the TGA to start these studies in Australia. So we're focused on cost-effective and efficient small proof of concept studies in rare or pediatric diseases that have a neurological effect. And then we use that information to really meet out our dossier, if you like, to then work with the Food and Drug Administration to secure what's called an investigational new drug application or IND.
Suppose, Tom, when it comes to medicinal cannabis firms listed on the ASX, why would you urge investors to take a look at Neurotech? What's your edge? What's your point of difference?
Yeah, so it's interesting you say that. It's a really good question because we, at the start I mentioned this, we are treating our extract as a drug product for purposes of securing a regulatory approval in an indication where we have substantial evidence of efficacy and safety. So if you look at some companies, and it's not a criticism, it's just a strategy they have, it's more to basically produce an extract which they cannot make certain medical claims about and then sell that to either through pharmacists or GPs to needy patients. We're taking a higher, if you like, a higher risk approach that has massive revenue rewards at the back end, and that is, well, let's show that it works in certain patients, let's receive approvals, let's receive a medical claim, and then let's receive reimbursement. And from those elements, you can generate many, many hundreds of millions of dollars in commercial sales. And I guess that's our main differentiator. The other fact is our strain of cannabis is very low in THC, which is a big no-no if you're treating kids. And also it's very high in something called CBDA. And CBDA is we liken that to the prodrug, which really helps all these other cannabinoids to do their job. And that's that entourage effect to see a higher level of clinical benefit. So we've differentiated ourselves on strategy, we differentiate ourselves on composition, and we differentiate ourselves on actual neurological disorders we're treating. So a bunch of our peers are focused on other indications that are quite separate and distinct from ours. So we think the whole space is fabulous, and we think it's really going to be a strong space for many years, but we're taking it as a drug.
Tom, good to speak. Thanks for your time.
Andrew, thank you very much. Take care.